Hello, 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 everybody. This is your man, Jay Takashi, guys. I'm here to bring you another episode review of Kanojo Mo Kanojo Season 2, Episode 3 review. Now, I'm not going to say a lot of things happened. There are some things that I want to talk about in this episode particularly. So we're gonna get to it, try to make this short as possible under 8 minutes or 8 minutes top. So let's get into it. And also, if you are new to the channel, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. It helps my channel, helps progress it. Also, be sure to share the video, help the algorithm. Like I said, guys, support and help this channel become even better. With that being said, let's get into it now. Now, in this episode, guys, we're continuing from episode 2 to the festival. And where Naoya Shino, Saki, I'll call Saki for sure. Saki, and Milika, are all at the festival trying to spend time with Naoya, trying to get his attention. Particularly, you know, originally he went there to spend time with those two. With Nagisa and Saki, and throughout the episode, throughout the festival they're attending, you know, Milika decides, you know, to really push herself forward and really make a compelled argument, you know, like, you know, I really do love you, Naoya, things of that nature, and now you're just reject. Now you're can't or he cannot force himself to like someone else, even though he knows that Milika is attractive and he may possibly like her, but he's committed to Nagisa and Saki. And just Milika trying to hear those, Milika, like, you know, being persistent as she is, she hears those words. It's not more so the shock of him saying no, it's more so like, so he did think about it, so she felt some type of way, even though she is crying and, you know, feeling her emotions over the place. Which, by the way, and don't worry, I'll say this very last, let me say that. And, you know, Shino's still having lingering feelings that are there that she's trying to keep bottled up. You know, now you're being nice as she is. You know, she trips, you know, breaks her slipper. Her quote-unquote, not her slipper, her sandal. I'm sorry, guys, I said slipper. And now he decides to help her up in a part of the episode. He's literally trying, you know, I'll carry you to the first aid. Things like that, and also he's carrying a young girl who got lost, who got lost from her friends while he's trying to help her. So he helps. So he actually helps the kid, the little girl first. You know, she finds a place, and then he takes, you know, to the first aid tent. and she literally talks about, you know, you shouldn't be so nice to me. You should be with Saki. You know, try to not to two time, things of that nature. She's really adamant on doing this. And one thing I would say about Shino, she's consistent. She's trying to make sure that her friend ends up in the best position with the guy that she likes. Even though Shino's sick, we still has lingering feelings there. But she's trying to forget her feelings and actually trying to make sure she pushes this forward. And she is getting frustrated because she feels like now you're just too nice to anybody and too honest. So that's kind of like what's kind of like stabbing her in the back a little bit and trying to like get her to go not go as super crazy as she is, because she's very conflicted. So that continues, and we literally have now about like near the end of the episode trying to look for Saki and Nagisa so they can find a good spot to watch the fireworks. You may know Hanabi. And quote unquote, is with him looking for them. Now, with that being said, guys, like I said, I think a lot of emotions were released in this episode. You know, you had some, you know, like I said, you had lingering feelings on Shino's end. Shino's dilemma of her trying to help Saki while still trying to, like, you know, while Naoya is kind of like not pushing, but really showing her his character. And it's just like it goes a testament to show how honest of a good guy Naoya is, even though he is kind of straightforward, dumb a little bit. But I'm just saying, like, he's really honest and straightforward and direct with things. And you know how Milika actually, you know, says, you know, why don't you see what you see? what you see in Saki and Nagisa, like, you know, you should just date me, things like that. And, you know, girls really trying to press the issue, trying to be aggressive. Not girls, just her trying to be aggressive to really showcase that she really doesn't feelings for the guy, or that she just wants him to date him because she feels like he understands her. So, she is beautiful. Let's just keep it real. All the girls are pretty in some regards, so I can't blame them. But, like, I'm not going to lie, man. This is probably the craziest four-way girls trying to go for one guy I've ever seen. In this case, 3 out of 4. One girl's not, the other 3 are. Well, 2 are dating him, and the other one's trying to go for him. So I do find it, like, very crazy that the series is kind of, like, based off this. And still off the praise that it gets for being as good as it is. Like I said, it was just, like, characters just mostly being shown. And Nagisa, actually, shout out to Nagisa for showing her fish skills to actually catch koi fish. Shout out to her. Really good characters, had a lot of good scenes in here. And like I said, it's really showing, like, how, you know, feelings for someone can really push somebody to do certain things. Not in a bad way, but to really push your issue to them. Now, with that said, guys, so those are my thoughts and the review of the episode itself. I'm looking forward to episode 4. And with that being said, guys, be sure to drink some green tea. Be sure to drink some water. Please be sure to exercise. And with all that being said, y'all, Jamata. So.